Mom? Mom? Mom?
Every day I come home to see my mom.
No, it certainly isn't. Honey, you could use a wash.
Well, it's a long walk from the station.
Well, why didn't you call?
I did call.
Oh, you know, sometimes I take the phone off the hook when I'm resting. I'm sorry.
Well, I hitched a short bit on Mr. Miggleson's tractor.
Boy, I'm gonna hear about that at the lady's age.
A gossip about me hasn't killed you yet.
No, but it's not for lack of trying.
Make fun, but I have done a lot of interesting things in my life.
Well, I think that a husband is interesting, and you don't have one of those.
Let's get you lying down.
I haven't heard that in a long while.
Mama!
Oh, don't you be so scandalized, little city girl.
Well, I'm not in the city now. I'm home to help my mom, so no more laundry for you.
Oh, I'm gonna have to lie down naked if I don't do the laundry. Oh, and then there really will be a scandal.
From Footlight Parade. We saw it twice at the Old Fox Theater in the city.
Three times.
What you working on?
You Afghan. I ordered over easy.
Well, they got scrambled on the way.
Put that pan to soak. I'll take care of it later. You're still a wizard in the kitchen, I see.
Fix a truck for you this afternoon. Mm-hmm.
Fancy secretary, time and pistons.
You may recall, during the war, I spent 3 years building B-29s. Know my way around machines.
Well, at least that GD war gave you something useful.
There are a pair of overalls around here I can use.
Don't go worrying about that truck. That's on my to-do list. Don't you argue with me. At least not on your first morning home.
So, tell me again what the doctor said.
I've told you 6 times already. You don't listen, Rosie. Just said my arthritis is getting worse. I should come home, rest.
I'll fix the truck for you. What else can I do?
Slow down. Kicking up a lot of dust.
I'm here to get things done. My company only hired a temp for 3 weeks. If I don't make it back in time, she keeps my job. Thank you kindly. Not a problem, miss.
Rose Miller! Why, look at you, Rosie. Come on, Jean.
Always an eyeful. Jean, you go along. Tell the pastor I'll be there in a few minutes. Jean, no running. My grandson.
The accordionist. Around here?
Chaplain.
He's a priest?
No, they call him that because he's silent.
In my experience, that's not an excuse to be rude. Oh,
he's deaf and dumb.
Oh.
Rosie, honestly, the liquor store?
We were out.
But you send someone. That's not a place for a nice young lady.
Florence, when have you ever known me to be a nice young lady?
Doing back in town?
Macy Comstock.
I'm impressed you held on to that factory.
Several people came up to me at Charlie's funeral, scared, asking if I was gonna shut the place down.
Why didn't you?
I thought about it. No one left in the family to run it.
The men don't give you trouble?
Once I showed them I was serious about learning, they got serious about teaching me. And here we are, 5 years down the road.
How long?
We haven't been back in what?
Year and a half.
That was the worst winter we've had in 20 years.
Ugh, almost didn't make it back to Chicago. Nearly lost my job.
You still happy there?
Absolutely. I live in an apartment on my own. I shop at department stores, museums, nightclubs.
Do you still see movies? I remember you and your mother used to always see Sunday matinees in the city.
Still go.
Oh, with someone special?
Oh, no, no, no. All the men I meet want me to quit my job. Keep house.
Anna, you remember Rose? Come say hello, please. She just loves her books.
You are so grown up.
Anna, say hello.
Hello. I know I'm not around much, but I know all sorts of secrets about your mother from when she was young. And I can be bribed. Chocolate or the loan of your bicycle.
Now, don't be telling her about all the trouble we used to get into.
Mom!
I didn't mean to embarrass you, darling.
It's just embarrassing yourself.
Flying down to Rio.
Ginger, Fred, foreheads never stop touching.
They had that dance floor. It was all made of pianos.
Wore my hair like hers for years.
Rosie, you're always trying to find that special little something.
The Saturday photos.
Mm-hmm. I found them in a box. It was next to the old mangle down in the basement. I'm just gonna get them all labeled. What year is this?
1933, like the gold diggers.
We're in the money, yeah. We're in the money.
I ran into Florence.
Uh-huh.
She didn't know you were feeling poorly.
Well, I don't want her to, because she's gonna tell everybody. I'm gonna be up to my neck and pity that I don't want, and a whole bunch of hot dishes I'm not even gonna eat.
Suit yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Oh, boy. After every matinee, we'd take a picture in front of the marquee. What I wouldn't give to just see one more movie musical.
Why don't we?
The nearest theater's 40 miles away.
We have your truck.
Be rattled to bits.
Well, I'll ask Macy. She'll loan us her car. We'll drive to the suit and we will catch a matinee.
Rosie, I can't even sit still at the supper table.
The pills from the doctor.
I am not taking those damn goofballs.
They're perfectly safe.
Yeah, that's what they told your father after the war, and he wasn't ever the same.
I'm trying to do something special for you.
Honey, I don't want special. I just want normal. 2 hours in the car and 3 hours at the matinee. I don't do that anymore.
Fine.
Partner again.
Thank you so much for coming tonight, and I just wanted to welcome you all to the annual Sioux Steam Community Dance. I know my husband Charlie would be so happy to know that we've kept on the family tradition. So please, have some pie and punch and dance the night away and have a bunch of fun, all right?
Anna, will you dance with me?
No.
Oh, come on, please. I love to dance. You will too.
No. Please.
I'm Rose Miller.
Well, how do you do?
Oh. And you are?
Mrs. Albert Claring.
Lovely. And your name?
Mrs. Albert Claring.
I don't mean to be unkind. Is your whole love on your mind, darling?
You remember Dave Jenkins? His wife died a few years ago.
Oh.
What's up, little brother?
Enough.
Well, look at that. Anna has a crush. I remember my first crush.
Me too, but that was a lifetime ago.
You ever think about finding a man? Maybe getting married again?
I think about finding someone, just not getting married again.
And you? Do you ever want to belong to someone?
Belong to someone? Can't believe you just said that. Madam factory boss, modern independent woman.
Like I told you last night, I'm happy to loan you my car, but she's a grown woman, and it doesn't sound like she wants to go.
I just wish you could see a movie without leaving Beersford.
The only way you're gonna see a movie in this town is if you make it yourself. You want the last piece?
Why not?
It's all yours.
Why not? Making a movie can't be harder than building a plane.
What sort of trouble are you hatching, Rose Miller?
What is a movie musical anyway? A camera, some film, some beautiful young people dancing. We can do that right here.
I'm not so sure we have any of those things in this town.
And it doesn't need to be 2 hours long. It's gonna be easy. Mom's gonna get her movie without leaving Beersford.
I am so glad you're back. Ugh, things have gotten boring around these parts.
Thank you.
Hello. Hello. Hi. I'm Rose, Macy's friend. I think she told you I was coming.
I'm making a film for my mother.
Chaplin, we need a movie camera. Great. Do you have one?
Oh, no.
No. A camera. We're looking for a camera, but small, like during the war. Excuse me. Well, I don't know how I'm supposed to explain anything to you. Wonderful. Does it work? That is just beautiful. No, I'd like to take a look at it before you go taking it apart. I want to know how it works. I'll be back Monday.
Hi, Anna. Your mother said I'd find you here.
What you reading?
Your mother mentioned the movie I'm making.
Yeah. I'm gonna need a leading lady.
Will you be my star?
No, thank you.
Why not?
Not exactly the actress type.
Anna, I think you'll make the audience fall in love with you.
It's impossible. I can't make faces and cry in front of people.
Many actors can make dramatic poses, but very few can evoke true emotion.
Do you really think that I can?
I do.
I'll have to ask my mom.
I already did.
Okay, I'll do it.
And let's ask that boy from the dance.
Which one?
The one who looks like a young Cary Grant.
Dale?
Yes.
No, he's busy. He works at the soda fountain and he plays basketball.
Let him decide that.
Welcome to Duars. What can I get you two today?
Oh dear. The deer. They're impressive.
Well, that one's a ram.
Right you are. From the Black Hills. Maybe Rankin Ridge?
I think so. Are you from around here?
Not anymore. I'm Rose. Rose Miller. Dale, truth be told, Anna and I have dropped in because we have something to ask you. We'll be making a movie in the next few days, and we're looking for actors. What do you say?
To what?
To be in a film.
No, thank you.
Why not?
Actors memorize the lines. I can't do that.
My movie's a musical. There's not many lines.
I can't sing.
It's a silent musical. You don't even have a microphone.
You don't even have to sing or say anything, really.
No sound.
No sound.
I wouldn't know what to do.
Do you play any sports?
He plays basketball.
Captain, 2 years.
Who tells you what to do in the game?
Coach Phillips.
I will be your coach. I'll tell you where to stand, where to move, and how to do everything.
Doesn't that sound like fun?
Yes, ma'am.
Call me Rose. We will stop by tomorrow to fit you for your costume, and shooting begins as soon as the film comes in from Chicago.
Yes, ma'am. I mean, Rose.
Oh, holy cow, look at this. It's your Theta Bera period. Tell me what you were thinking.
Jeepers, look who's talking. Daddy gave you endless grief for that hairdo.
Now, see, you could do no wrong, but let me step out of an apron, and he about blew a gasket.
That's putting it mildly. Okay, what do you think about 1937?
No, it's 39.
Well, I already have it in ink.
Well, scratch it out.
Well, a few years difference won't matter.
It will matter. When you look back, it's going to matter. Oh, that's what I was looking for. I look like Myrna Loy in...
Thin Man, 1934. That was my favorite.
I thought you liked the musicals best. Until you discovered boys, and then you'd be gone from the intermission to the closing credits.
You're exaggerating.
Oh, Mama, the line at the concession stand. It was just so long.
I didn't know you even missed me. Eyes were glued to the screen.
That was our time together.
I'm gonna hang a sheet in that corner. Pretty soon we will have our own little matinee.
Hi there! Jeepers! I'm Rose Miller, nice to meet you.
Ah, Pearl's daughter. Macy said you'd be coming around.
Yeah, back in town, temporarily, from Chicago, and planning to make a film. A movie.
Huh.
I think your land here is perfect. I'd be hugely grateful to you if you'd consider letting me use it as a location. That's where you make a film. Using a location is a very modern idea, actually. And the script, I'll be writing the script. That's the movie's story.
Will it be narrative or expressionist?
Excuse me?
Sure, you can use whatever you want. I'll actually be around to help out.
It arrived this morning. No. I need to test it, see if it works. How are we supposed to work together if we can't communicate? You think of everything. Great. Yeah. Chaplin. Your name is James. I'm so sorry. I didn't know. Rose. I built bombers during the war. An executive secretary. Do you like it? It's very important.
job.
I feel like an idiot. I've spent years trying to impress people who think I'm inferior and who just want me to be quiet and go away. People think your skills are less for no good reason. That's why I work for myself.
The book says that the film needs a director and also a camera specialist. Will you be my camera man? You have eyes, don't you? You can see just fine.
Okay, but I want to see the edge of the flat. The edge of the flat. What? What? Just... Okay, this is for my mother. She loves fantasy. Just do what I say. This is going to work. Just do this. Okay.
You too. Get to the edge, and then come in when I start you.
Florence!
I brought a rhubarb cake for you to take to Pearl.
Are you expecting Pearl to come watch soon?
Oh, I don't believe so. Nace, so much to do at the house.
Her arthritis problem improving, then?
Oh, you know Pearl, no complaints.
Mm-hmm. Well, if that's the way she wants to play it.
Well, this was wonderful of you, Pearl. We'll be pleased. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. What's that on her head?
It's a headdress. We're channeling a dance from the Ziegfeld Girls.
Try shake your head.
Get me some chicken wire and pliers.
I'll go get some.
Jean, I'm gonna need an assistant. Would you be willing to take good notes and do what I say?
Yes, ma'am.
We'll get along just fine.
All right, everybody, let's rehearse. Places.
Places.
Much louder.
Places!
Good, come with me. I go to Macy's. I'm gonna go fix dinner.
I'm not hungry yet.
I won't burn it this time, I promise.
Did you hear back from your job? What are you gonna do if they don't give you any more time off?
Rosie.
Rose. Honey, come on, sit down for a minute. You know, I worry about you every single day.
I'm fine.
Which part's fine? Living in that box of an apartment that you call home all by yourself?
Being a part of something bigger than this.
Bigger than this? This is ours. This is all ours.
There's not enough here for me. Mom, be honest. Wouldn't you have lived in the city? You could have. The museums, the stores, the excitement.
All that concrete? All that noise?
Quiet here is too loud for me.
Going on? Well, that's your right.
Just don't want anybody feeling sorry for me.
What you don't want is to admit you're just like the rest of us. Pearl, you have helped me throughout the years. You've been there for me. And if you don't let me help you now, you're keeping me in your debt. And that's just mean. Now, are you going to be a bathrobe hypocrite, or can I sign you up for a visit from the AIDS Society tomorrow?
Everyone, gather around! Ladies and gentlemen, film is very, very expensive and the rain might be coming, so we can't afford to make any mistakes. Do you all feel ready to do this?
Yes.
James. James, is the camera ready? Great. No. Just do this. Okay, let's do this.
Let's do this!
Scene one, take one. And the orchestra music comes in, and da 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 da. Cut!
Cut!
Scene one, take two. Scene one. Take three, take four. Scene one, take 17.
Hold on.
Hold on.
What are you doing? Just do what I say.
James. James! Sorry.
I'm sorry. I should ask you and not tell you. We're never going to understand each other. So I should get somebody else. I don't want anybody else. I want you. Now, how do you want to communicate? What?
He seems so angry.
What do those hand signals mean?
I don't know.
Do you think Rose needs help? So, what are you going to do after you graduate? I plan on going to Indiana or Iowa.
What would you study?
Ag, probably. My dad says that no one knows his land better than he does. But I know I could raise production, learn the new fertilizers and machines.
Like robots?
Farm robots.
Wonder how long this is gonna take. I don't wanna walk home in the dark.
I could walk you.
Really?
Yeah, my dad would have my hide if he knew I let you walk home alone in the dark.
Okay. James, whatever it is, I'll learn. James! James! Need a lift, Mr. Mill?
Sister, do I ever.
Today.
There's your mom. Guess you don't need me.
Do you want a ride?
No, I'll just run.
Hop in. Never, ever speak to me again.
Turn, and then a swoop. Turn and a swoop. It's...
Maybe it'll look like it's supposed to be a comedy.
It's a silent musical. Running out of time.
Your job wants you back.
And James.
And James.
I tried to tell him what to do, and he quit.
What?
He quit.
Well, you have to get him back.
How? It feels like whatever I write down is half of what I mean.
Well, I've always believed Chaplin, I mean, James, to be smart. I mean, obviously he's smarter than he shows.
He says there's a sign language. Have you heard of this?
No, but he did go to a school for the deaf up near Sioux Falls.
Really?
That's where he was when we were kids.
Huh.
It's not a language. It's more like a slang or patois. We forbid it in the classroom.
Why?
It's a crutch. They need to learn to read lips, or they'll never be able to integrate into society.
I never thought of that.
Well, Imagine you were different, ostracized, an outsider, never allowed to participate in the grand pageant of life. What you'd want most is a way to fit in, to find a job, get married, be like everyone else. That's what we can give them.
But when deaf people talk, I mean, not talk, but to each other, they sign.
Why do you want to learn it?
Well, I've become friends with a former student here, James Hansen.
I remember James. He could really take it to the hoop. He never learned to audiate well or to read lips, but the pheasants kicked the stuffing out of the Flandreau Indians the year he led the team. Has he found his place in the world?
I think he has.
Good. I worry about them. So reliant on the kindness of others.
Couldn't you teach me just a few signs? Hello, goodbye, and thank you.
Your desire to communicate with James is admirable. But I can't teach you any signs because I don't know any.
Go get some ice. There's a cafeteria key.
Hello. Excuse me.
She went to the school nurse.
Are you using sign language? Can you teach me?
I'm not supposed to use sign language on school grounds.
But you use it somewhere else. I would like to communicate with a deaf friend of mine, respectfully. No one else in the town is deaf, and he doesn't read lips.
He should learn.
Is that what you really think?
I can't afford to get fired.
Are you finished with work? Because I borrowed a friend's car to get here, and we could go to a diner, and we'll get a meal, and you can teach me whatever I can learn in a couple of hours. Deal?
I went to school. Your school. Go bed. Nice. I'm good. Yes, please. Oh, please. I like that.
Frog. Oh.
B-O. Why, boy. 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 Oh, dog. Dog. Rooster. Rooster.
We are.
Lord, we thank you for them.
He needs his hands to say grace.
Oh.
Lord, thank you for the man before us. I don't understand.
Well, I understand. I understand just fine. Amen.
Amen.
Don't keep those potatoes to yourself.
Beautiful. What? What's the sign? You don't know? Well, what does one do when one doesn't know the sign? You and me think a sign. Cigarette, match. You're throwing the matches. That's ugly. Okay. You're slow. Had a good day. I had good. Driving.
good day, too. Good.
Mom?
I'm taking a bath.
The film is back on track. I convinced James to continue being my cameraman. That's so good because he turns the most ordinary things into something unique.
He has the artist's touch. It's pretty cool.
And Mom, everyone is enjoying himself so much. You should see Anna. She's blossoming. And you are going to love Dale's costume.
Rosie?
Mm-hmm, yes?
Did you come here? Yeah.
What is that?
It's a tumor. I have cancer in my breast.
Maybe your arthritis.
It's the same as it ever was.
I just didn't want to tell you.
Well, they have treatments, surgery.
They can cut it out, but it takes half the chest. Most women don't survive that surgery. And the rest can hardly stand up.
Well, we have to do something.
Honey. I think that for the first time in my life, I've earned the right to do absolutely nothing.
here by your mother, Miss Miller. But we agreed that if you didn't return after 3 weeks, Miss Jefferson would keep your position. You may have to return to the general pool, but that will be up to the office manager.
Did you take those boxes of pictures back down to the basement?
As soon as I'm back.
Set my clock to that.
Mom, you said you want me to finish the film, yes?
I do.
Farmer's Almanac says we run out of light at 8:02 tonight. I will be home then.
Farmer's Almanac.
Marlon Brando lived in a veterans hospital for weeks to play a paraplegic.
Why?
Method acting. You really live the truth of it all the time. We should try it. All the big movie stars are doing it.
I'm game.
So we act as if we're in love all the time.
How do we do that?
Break.
15-minute break!
Thank you, Jean.
Should I follow you?
No, you take a break, too. Sure. Yes, whatever you want. Please, come on. We are running out of time. I am running out of time. Please, we have so much work to do. We have to figure out what the next dance is gonna... Beautiful. Thank you.
place.
All right, everyone. Give James some space. James, action.
Well, this should hold you for another week. Rose, dear, will you help me with where to put these?
Just leave that there. I'll get to them later.
I just need you for a minute. In here. You've been spending a lot of time with the chaplain.
James is wonderful company.
Be that as it may, he is deaf.
I hadn't noticed.
It's a serious defect, Rose. In my day, we did what was necessary to make sure that wasn't passed on.
Like a gelding.
Dear, Chaplin has a decent place in this community, with his business. But you should never be alone with him.
Do you honestly think he'd attack me?
Of course not. But you don't want to give the wrong impression to the real men in town you might actually want to marry. Now, there are casseroles in the icebox. I want you to make sure Pearl eats.
I need this by Monday. All right. Thank you. Miss, please make sure he understands how important it is for Monday. Thank you.
I have an idea. You should put up a sign. Yeah, useful requests, phrases. Requests. And people come in and just point. Yeah, maybe like a list. A, this. B, that. C. What? I just want to make it easier.
Oh.
I just want to make it easier. James. 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 Rental. Repair. Camera. Projector. Paid. Cash.
Has the Afghan coming?
Spirit's willing, but flesh is weak. Yeah, what's the matter?
Having some trouble with my cameraman. It's all over now. Get that laundry done.
Hey, honey.
I've got 30 women in this town who can do my laundry and make hot casseroles and clean my kitchen. I only got one daughter.
I'm sorry, Mom. I always try to do what I think is right. It's just not enough.
Honey, if you're with me, that's enough.
So you put the hook in the middle.
Here.
Yeah, where the hole is, good.
I like this.
Crocheting's very relaxing.
No, giving up.
Do you want some advice?
Of course.
You didn't always.
Well, you didn't usually ask me before delivering it.
Fair enough.
I'd love to know.
All right, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Imagine your picture of happiness. Anybody there? Are you alone?
No.
Who's there?
You are.
That's nice, but not forever. Anybody that you pick to stand next to you should have that same picture of happiness, because if they don't, they're going to be in the business of changing you, and you're going to be in the business of changing them, and that is just not a profitable business.
When did you get so smart?
Same time that you stopped knowing everything. Probably last week. Try it again.
boss.
You want a deaf woman. You want to move to the city? There's deaf people, different jobs, maybe easier. Okay, imagine, envision. What do you see? Close your eyes.
Hi, Rose.
Give me your hand. Your mother and I first bought this color at Montgomery Ward's when we were your age.
To the barn tomorrow night.
What's going on?
You'll have to see. Bring a blanket. Hope you don't mind. Finished it.
Movie? Mm-hmm. Everybody came.
Good evening.
almost everyone here tonight gave us something so that we could make this movie. So grateful to all of you, but I'm most grateful to the woman who imagined it all, Rose Miller. Can I get some light, please? Oh, it's for my hands. Thank you. My mother loved the movies. I think she loved sitting in the dark with emotions she wouldn't dare express in the light. I used to think she imagined herself as a character in a movie, that she wanted to exist in different lands, have amazing adventures. But you know what? I was wrong. She loved watching the magic, but not as much as she loved being in the light of this place. This is where she watch the movie.